We didn't know how we were going to cope. We didn't know what the next few months would bring. It was just terrifying. It won't be
long now, love. Just over 2 years ago, Charlotte and Stuart Nash's daughter Zoe was diagnosed with leukemia.
The first 8 to 9 months of treatment is the most intense with acute lymphoblastic leukemia. They have to completely restart her immune system, so there is no immune system, and then her body has to create a new immune system.
In the meantime, you have another baby, Bronte arrives. How did the family have to adjust?
We suddenly had to become very insular and isolated. We had to limit the number of people Zoe came into contact with.
Bye!
For more than 2 years, Zoe's family committed to serious social distancing while her immune system was gaining strength.
How did you not go crazy?
I'm still not sure. I mean, technically, maybe I am. But we came up with different strategies.
And some of those strategies could be useful for any parent locked down at home with a toddler.
One, create a routine and stick to it.
We had this large picture-based routine chart of different activities that we'd be doing throughout the day. That just created a level of routine for Zoe to have some familiar events cycling through the week.
To rotate the toys. Kids have got more toys than they know what to do with.
Charlotte organised Zoe's toys into different tubs, which she rotated through the week.
By the time they got back to the first toy box, it would be like a new set of toys again.
Lastly, it's really stressful being stuck in the same four walls. So make sure you tag team the care. Let one person look after the kids whilst the other person goes for a walk to get out of the house.
I think a lot of parents right now have got a newfound respect for teachers and what they deal with every single day. Do you think we have to sort of relax a bit on our expectations of whether or not we're going to be good homeschool teachers?
I think so, because we're not teachers. And we're going to struggle with that role because that's not what we've been trained to do. We need to understand that crisis schooling is not homeschooling.
So, having gone through years of isolation, how does it feel being locked down once again?
Absolutely heartbreaking, honestly. It's been really, really, really hard for me personally. It felt like a tsunami sort of coming back towards you again, because I thought we're supposed to be moving away from this. I thought we could go to the movies and do all those things that we hadn't done in 2 and a bit years. And suddenly it's just been taken away from us again for no known period of time.
Gentle. Whoa.
And what are your favourite games to play at home with mummy?
Skittles.
Skittles.
And ponies and fairies.
It is also going to be something that will finish and will end, and it is survivable. We will get through this.
Alrighty. And what about those moments when you just want to scream?
Go outside and scream.
Just do it.
Just do it. The neighbours will probably scream back with you.
Yes.
She's phenomenal. I feel like such a brat for ever complaining during this time. When you think about people like Charlotte and Zoe who have been through this, I'm just getting emotional, who've been through all of that and now have to go through this as well.
Yeah, so true. And Zoe and her family were looking forward to getting away with the charity Camp Quality, but of course that's not possible right now. And the charity itself is really struggling under the current crisis. So if you would like to make a difference by making a donation to Camp Quality, all the details are on our website.